Questions 47 through 50. Listen to a talk given at a Museum of Natural History.
I'd like to welcome you all to the Museum of Natural History. Today's tour will take us through our newly renovated dinosaur exhibit, where we have the largest collection of dinosaur fossils anywhere in the world. Before we begin the tour, let me mention that there have been some major modifications to some of the exhibits over the past 3 years. Basically, these changes were made because of recent changes in the way scientists interpret dinosaur behavior. For example, when we get to the first room, you will be able to see that the Tyrannosaurus rex skeleton is no longer standing upright with its tail dragging on the floor. That's because paleontologists, as they examined the area around its footprints more closely, realized they could find no evidence of a heavy dragging tail, which would have left behind marks in the earth. In its new position, the backbone is parallel to the floor, its head is pushed forward, and its tail is stretched out, acting as a counterweight. This new pose stresses the relationship between dinosaurs and modern birds, and supports the theory that dinosaurs are actually more closely related to birds than to any other existing creature. Let me also point out that we have changed the way we group dinosaurs in our displays. There's a new school of thought called cladistics, where scientists determine relationships among the animals according to common physical characteristics. The Plateosaurus and the Oviraptor, for instance, are separated by 148 million years, but they are grouped together here because they both have a grasping forefoot and an S-shaped neck. Physical evidence that they are indeed related. So now the exhibition halls are arranged more like a family tree rather than the walk through time that they used to be.
Number 47. Why has the museum modified its dinosaur exhibit? Number 48. According to the speaker, what is the Tyrannosaurus rex's new position evidence of? Number 49. Why are the Plateosaurus and the Oviraptor displayed together? Number 50. How were the dinosaurs originally grouped in the exhibit? This is the end of Section 1, Listening Comprehension. Stop work on Section 1. This is a reminder. At the end of the test, the supervisor will collect all of the test books. Questions 47 through 50. Listen to a talk given at a Museum of Natural History.
I'd like to welcome you all to the Museum of Natural History. Today's tour will take us through our newly renovated dinosaur exhibit, where we have the largest collection of dinosaur fossils anywhere in the world. Before we begin the tour, let me mention that there have been some major modifications to some of the exhibits over the past 3 years. Basically, these changes were made because of recent changes in the way scientists interpret dinosaur behavior. For example, when we get to the first room, you will be able to see that the Tyrannosaurus rex skeleton is no longer standing upright with its tail dragging on the floor. That's because paleontologists, as they examined the area around its footprints more closely, realized they could find no evidence of a heavy dragging tail, which would have left behind marks in the earth. In its new position, the backbone is parallel to the floor, its head is pushed forward, and its tail is stretched out, acting as a counterweight. This new pose stresses the relationship between dinosaurs and modern birds, and supports the theory that dinosaurs are actually more closely related to birds than to any other existing creature. Let me also point out that we have changed the way we group dinosaurs in our displays. There's a new school of thought called cladistics, where scientists determine relationships among the animals according to common physical characteristics. The Plateosaurus and the Oviraptor, for instance, are separated by 148 million years, but they are grouped together here because they both have a grasping forefoot and an S-shaped neck. physical evidence that they are indeed related. So now the exhibition halls are arranged more like a family tree, rather than the walk through time that they used to be.
Number 47. Why has the museum modified its dinosaur exhibit? Number 48. According to the speaker, what is the Tyrannosaurus rex's new position evidence of? Number 49. Why are the Plateosaurus and the Oviraptor displayed together? Number 50. How were the dinosaurs originally grouped in the exhibit? This is the end of Section 1, Listening Comprehension. Stop work on Section 1. This is a reminder. At the end of the test, the supervisor will collect all of the test books.